Hi everyone, and welcome to the next lesson in this series on Django fundamentals. So what we'll be doing today is to simply carry out some profile management and go ahead and update our username and email for our users. So let's go ahead and get straight to that. Right, so the first thing we can do is we can go ahead to templates, profile, and we're going to create a profile management HTML template. Okay, and of course, it's quite obvious here what we're going to do. We're just simply going to be able to update our profile from this page here. Perfect. So just make sure you add that template. Okay, the next thing that we can go ahead and do is we can go to our to-do app, to our urls.py, and we can start to set up our URLs. So I'll go ahead and actually, I'm going to copy this comment here, and just under dashboard, I'm going to go and paste this comment here, of which I'll replace here in profile management. Okay, then of course I can just copy a URL pass here. I can just use dashboard's URL pass here. And I can just go ahead and as my route, my view and name, I'm just going to say profile management. So here I'll just go ahead and say profile dash management. Okay, the views, okay, I like to sometimes use underscores, so profile underscore management. And then for name, I can just go ahead and say profile dash management. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so that's our URL done. Now what we're going to do in the meantime, we're just gonna go to views.py. And we can go under dashboard, yeah. And we're just going to simply just, you know, pass the function. So I'm just going to reuse some code here. Okay, this will be our profile management page. And in the meantime, you know, I might as well just, yeah, I'm going to pass it actually. That will be better. So let's see what our view we stipulated to be. Profile underscore management. So I can just under here say profile underscore management. Great. Okay, I can remove this line here because we will alter it. So I'm just going to say pass for now. Okay, so that's where we are at the moment. All right. So next up, we're going to go ahead and create an update form in forms.py. All right. So let's go ahead to forms.py. And we can actually put it at the bottom. So I'm just going to copy this comment here. Like that. Okay, so I'm just going to say here, update a user. So this is the whole point of profile management. So I'm going to give it a class name. So in this case, I'm going to say class, and the name for the class is going to be update user form. Perfect. Now what's in it, I need to, of course, inherit Django model forms. So I can just say forms.model form, like so. Make sure to add a colon at the end, of course. Now we're going to get right to it. So the important thing to do here is we need to say password equals none. Okay, and the whole point of this is we do not want to utilize our password for the form. We don't want to be able to change that here. We just want to update our username and of course our email at this point. So like a normal Django model form, we can just say class meta. Ooh. Our model we need to set, so that will be user because we're altering user, and of course our fields, and we'll also exclude. So our fields, actually we can just reuse this here, this here, and we can just alter. So within the fields, I'm going to have username and I'm going to have email. Great. And all I'm going to exclude is the passwords, the password. So you need to put in password one and password two. Okay, now password one, of course, was, if you recall, when we registered a user, this is your actual password, and password two has to do with confirming your password. So just make sure you add that. Okay, and this is all we need for our form to update a user. Now we can go ahead to our views and we can import this form. Now we have our line here, which imports all the forms from forms.py. So we can simply just put a comma here and what is our form name? It is update user form. So I'm going to say update user form. Perfect. Now I'll just scroll down. Actually, not scroll down, up to here. Perfect. Okay, so that's where we are now. All right. So let's now write Python logic to allow us to update our username and email. First thing, we can actually go ahead straight and say if the request.method is equal to that of a post request. Okay, we can go ahead and say create a variable that will of course house our form and say update user form, and within it we're going to pass two parameters. The first one will be stipulating that we are going to be sending a post request, and the second one would be selecting a specific instance for our user. So first of all, we need to say again, this is going to be a post request. And then what we need to do for our second parameter, we need to say what the instance will be. Who is this referring to? Now our instance will be referring to the user that is currently logged in. So we can simply say request.user. Perfect. Okay, now let's go to the next part. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go ahead and check if our form is valid. So we can say if user form dot is underscore valid. Okay, so if there's any errors in our forms.py that we created here, we will check for that. Now, if there's no errors, we can simply go ahead and save our form, which means to push it to our database and post it. Okay, so once we've finished doing this, we want to redirect back to our dashboard. So upon completion. Great. So that is what we need to do for that. Now, another thing that we need to do and go ahead to do is we can write an else statement here saying, okay, user form, okay, else the user form will be update user form, and we want to automatically fill our form with the instance of our user. Okay, so just be sure that you add this as well. Okay. But what we can do is, okay, we do not have to explicitly go ahead and write an else statement. There are many ways that we can go ahead and do this. I mean, for example, we can just remove the else statement and just remove the indentation to move this to an if statement. But let's stay safe and use this for now. Okay, now we've done that. The last thing, of course, like we always do, we need to render our data to our template. So we can say context. Okay, and I'm going to set my key as user form, and of course, as we know, the value will be user form as well. Right, now what I can do now is I can go ahead and say return render, and I'm going to pass in a few things. So request, and then I'm going to output the HTML template, and we can see that this is situated on the profile and profile management. So I can just go ahead here and say profile / profile dot management. This is our template. Perfect. And I'm going to set context is equal to context. Right, just like so. So just bear that in mind. Okay, so that part is done. Right, okay. So I just realized I made a mistake on my part here. Apologies. So we shouldn't have an else statement here. Okay, we need to bring this out. And the reason for this is basically when we run our profile management template here, by default, we want to see a user form already with data from that user. That's the reason that we're passing instance in here. So we want to already see pre-populated information on our current username and password. We don't want to see a blank field when we're updating. We want to see what we are going to update. That is the whole purpose of this. And by putting it in an else statement is not the right way of doing it. Okay, because that will only run after checking if the form is invalid. We want it to run immediately when we're on the page. That's why we put it outside by the if statement here. Okay, great. Okay, so let's see. So next, we need to, of course, plan our entry point. So we will get to the profile management page through dashboard. So it would be great here to just put a simple link here. I think we have too many buttons on our navigation bar. So we can simply just borrow from delete task, this URL here, okay. And I'm just gonna say profile management as our route. Okay, of which I'm gonna say here, profile management. Okay, perfect. Now we have an entry point to profile management. But pre-fall management has nothing. So we can simply just use everything from create task. It's going to use the same sort of logic. So we can just copy from there. And I'm just going to update a few things here, such as the title to say profile management, which is perfect. Okay, here I'm going to say update your profile. Okay, that's fine. Okay, now let's see what we're using here. So let's move this. We are expecting a key value to be user form. So expecting a key. Right, so we can just switch this around. So we have user form here as our key. Yep, perfect. Now we must also change our attribute since we're expecting a username. And we can go back to user form here as our key, and we're expecting an email. Now, if you're wondering where I'm getting these attributes from, it's from forms.py, since we are expecting a username and an email, and we're excluding the password fields. So just keep that in mind. Okay, I think that does it. And let's actually go and test this out. So just log in with your normal user that you've created. Log in. Okay, we can see we have a link here now that will redirect us to profile management. Okay, and this is what we want to see. So we can update our profile, our username is automatically pre-populated, and our email is already populated for us. Now, this is what I meant earlier on, and I said I'll explain this. So this is what this line does here. Now, this won't work in an else statement, of course, because this is going to only appear after our form has been submitted. But that doesn't make sense because we need to actually see our data. So basically what we're doing here, okay, we have our username and email, and what we're doing is showing our user form here, update user form in our context. And the reason why we can already see our username and our email address is because of the fact that we are setting a unique instance based on the user that is logged in. So we are going to see each user that creates an account and logs in, we will see his or her username and email address because we are selecting it by instance according to the user. Okay, so I just thought I would explain that to bring a bit more clarity. So let's actually go ahead and actually test this. Right, so let's go back here. And I'm just going to change the username to Arno97, and we can say update. And based on update, we will be redirected to dashboard if this all works. Okay, there we go. So it should have worked. So if we go back to profile management, we can see our username has been updated. Let me just change that back. Great. Now let's go back and let's test the email address. Let's see if it actually updates. I'm going to switch this now to Arno97. And I'm going to actually, let's make it interesting. Yeah, let's put an Arno97 and update. Go back. Okay, email has worked. Now let's update both at the same time. So we can see this works successfully if we update a form at a time with one button. But now let's do double or nothing. So I'm going to say here 99 and test 99. So we're both updating both fields now. Let's update. And it works great. Now, you're probably wondering, our username is unique in Django, or it should be. What happens if we are trying to update our username if there's another user with that username? Good question. Let's test that theory out. So let's put it for now back to the usual. Okay, let's leave it as default. Okay, so Arno96 is our username. Now let's go ahead and log out, register. So I'm going to go ahead and register another user called Arno97. And I'll explain now what I'm doing here. So I'm going to say test100@gmail.com. So go ahead and just create another user. It doesn't matter what the username is for now. So just register that user. And go ahead and just check out that profile of that user. Okay, so we have a user currently called Arno97 with the email address of test100@gmail.com. Let's go ahead and log out. And let's log in with our main user here. So in this case, Arno96. So let's go to profile management and let's attempt to actually change our username. So let me show you, for example, what happens if we are able to change that username. Let's say I put here Arno94, update. Upon succession, and if this is correct, we're going to always redirect to the dashboard. If for some reason we do not redirect to the dashboard, then it's not allowing us to submit this form. Hence, there must be something wrong. Either there's a validation error that comes up or something's up. So let's change that back now. Great. Now, remember our previous user was called Arno97. So I'm going to go ahead here and just say 97. And you'll see our page is just simply refreshing. We cannot make this change because there is another user with this username. Now, of course, this will be helpful to have validation messages. But as you can see here, it is not allowing us to do that because Django has built-in functionality to make sure that all usernames in Django are unique. Okay, and this is a great thing here. Now, if we simply just say Arno96, no problem. And the same thing goes for if we were to log into our Arno97 account. Okay, this should be obvious here, but I'm just going to go over it. If I were to choose over an existing user who's Arno96 and I update, it's not going to allow me to update the profile because that username has been taken. Of course, it will be helpful to have validation in here as a message, but I just wanted to show you the basics here of updating our username and how to update our email address. Okay, so I hope that was helpful. And that's it for today's sort of lesson. Thank you very much.